We are now joined by renowned author Patricia Cornwell. She is relaunching her electrifying, best-selling, thrilling series that follows Dr. K. Scarpetta in another suspense-filled installment called Autopsy. With more than 115 million books sold worldwide in more than 120 countries and 29 New York Times bestsellers, Cornwell has kept us on the edge of our seats in suspense for decades now. Thank you so much for joining us, Ms. Cornwell.
Well, thank you for having me.
Okay, so take us back. It was 2016. You really kind of decided you were going to quit Dr. Scarpetta, right? Although you in turn said now that she really had fired you.
I think she did. I think she knew what she was doing, too.
It sounds like it's working out, really.
Well, it is working out, and I'll tell you why. I don't know how the book's going to do. I'm keeping my fingers crossed. But most of all, this going away and doing something else for a while and just jumping into the world of outer space and the new technologies and all the things, mm-hmm. Artificial intelligence, whatever. What I realized, after I got away from Scarpetta for 4 or 5 years and doing this kind of research, and then COVID is what caused me to go back to her. And I thought, you've got a whole new bag of tricks you can do with this lady, because we can work a death in outer space. Because, science is science, and up there, everything's physics. And just to give you a quick example, blood drips because of gravity. So imagine in weightlessness in outer space, what's going to happen to a crime scene? And I didn't really think much about that long ago, because why would I, Scarpetta, be dealing with somebody dying in outer space? Well, today that could really happen. And I show you what that's like in this new one.
But why did the pandemic actually inspire you to resurrect this character?
Well, like a lot of people, the pandemic was a game changer for me personally. Some people quit work during the pandemic and retired and are never going back. For me, what it made me realize is that there's a lot that I still want to do, and Scarpetta is my strongest voice. And I started thinking, I had some time out. I'd finished the two space thrillers. The last one came out in January. I was trying some screenwriting, and then I said, you're in lockdown. I don't even know what's going to happen to this planet. But what do you want to do, and what would make sense and be meaningful? And I thought, what would Dr. Scarpetta do in this world today if we threw her right into the same one we're living in with COVID, with January 6th, with the monuments being torn down in Richmond and the divisiveness in our society, and also the problems in space, because the space race is a really big thing, and there are already crimes being committed up there. It's just they're being committed from the ground. But there's going to be a day when we do have death, violence, tragedy beyond the surface of this planet. I'm surprised it hasn't happened, and we hope it doesn't, but it will, because humans will take their tragedies, their trials, their triumphs. We will take all of it with us everywhere we go.
And you've given us a little hint as far as the crime scene in space goes, but give us a little more of a taste of Autopsy and why you've compared it to Coke Classic.
It's Coke Classic because when I decided, okay, let's bring Scarpetta back, let's go back to what worked so well in the beginning. So I literally pulled out Postmortem, my very first one, mm-hmm. and I looked at it, I went through it, and I thought, what about this worked so well? And what about things that maybe didn't work as well later on in the series? And one thing I do know, people like a sense of place, and especially these days, that's why shows that are set in small towns are popular. We want to be hugged by something. Mm-hmm. All this remote stuff is difficult. So let's put them back in Virginia, where it all started. It's an emotional landscape. It's something I also know really well. Put them outside of Washington, though, so Scarpetta can be involved in the Doomsday Commission, which has to do with the sorts of threats that top secret people would talk about, the what ifs, like with cyber attacks, or if you weaponized a virus, let's just say. Or what about, the Russian doll satellites, when a satellite goes up and it opens and another one comes out and it opens and another, and then a weapon comes out. These are the kinds of things that those kinds of people talk about. So she, in the middle of serial murders happening in Northern Virginia, where she is the new chief medical examiner again, then she gets called to the White House because of a disaster in space that she has to guide astronauts through as to how to deal with it remotely. And then, of course, there are other things that go on. But all of it was to bring her back, make it old, but make it really new. I feel very good about that. I think those people, the readers who have always liked the earlier Scarpettas, are going to, I think they're going to like this a lot.
But you've said, and it's important to bring up to our viewers, that you don't have to read all 24 books before you get to this.
No, I didn't even have to read them to write it. It's a good thing. I don't have time to read 24 books. No, in fact, if you've never read a Scarpetta, this is the one to start with. And if you've only read a few, it absolutely doesn't matter. I wrote this to relaunch the series. And it's the characters you love. It's Scarpetta Marino, Scarpetta's sister Dorothy, of course Lucy. Lucy's involved in artificial intelligence, and there's a scene there that's going to really shock people when they see what she's doing. And it's just, I'm so pleased with it. You know, this was COVID's gift to me. I would not have done this book. I would not have brought Scarpetta back. I was done 5 years ago. I even got rid of a lot of my old forensic books. Because I thought, I'm not doing this anymore. I don't need some of this stuff.
But then you ended up going to NASA to actually really put on your researcher hat for this. And I'm curious just to get a sense, because you started as a reporter at the Charlotte Observer, how your background as a reporter really shapes your writing as a storyteller.
I would not be here today if I had not started out as a journalist. Journalism taught me how to go looking for a story until it finds you. And you got to go look. It just makes you got to go do something. You can't just sit there and wait for inspiration to land on your shoulder like a bird. And so when I really was going to put Scarpetta in this, at one of the things I also did, in fact, this pin I have on is given to me by Jack Fisher, an astronaut who was on the space station. And he's kind of my astro coach. And we talked a lot about what would it look like up there? Like, what does water do in outer space? What does blood do? What if someone gets injured? Tell me how these things look when you've got no gravity and with a gunfire. There's a lot of things so that's one of the things I did too.
And we just have about 30 seconds left, but I would like to also talk about Jamie Lee Curtis and your involvement making this in TV. Why now? Tell me what you're most excited about this new venture.
The thing I'm most excited about is that Jamie Lee Curtis is involved in it. She's a powerhouse. I've known her for a number of years. She's familiar with Scarpetta. She read Autopsy way back in the spring when I finished it, and I sent her the manuscript because she read it, and she called and she said, you know, she said, we should be doing this as a TV series. And I said, I was hoping you were going to ask.
Super excited about that. In the meantime, Autopsy, available wherever books are sold. Patricia Cornwell, we thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.